my channel. My name is Desiree, and for today's video, I'm going to be doing a get ready with me as well as a BoxyCharm unboxing. So I'm just going to try something a little bit different with my BoxyCharms as well as I'm getting ready. I'm going to be going to the beach today. So for today, I'm going to be using a combination of all kinds of products today. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to spritz my face with this. As you guys know, or if you don't know, I absolutely love this. I love to spray this all over my face after I've moisturized. And then I like to go in with this. This is a Touch and Soul face primer. And I like to just put this only where I need it most, which is typically here. On my top of my cheeks where I have the most largest pores. Okay, so now I'm gonna just pull my hair back with my little cat ears headband. Hopefully my hair stays put. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna go into with my box is by the Luscious, it's by the brand called Luscious Angel Eyes. And this is a eyeshadow primer base in nude. So I have been trying this out for a couple days now, and I'm kind of iffy about it. What I mean is that a little bit truly does go a long ways. So if you use a lot of this and you don't set it right away, it's not gonna be cute. Oop, dropping everything around here. Also, if you guys are wondering why I'm filming in this area, this is part of my kitchen. It's because it is like 6 in the morning and I decided to film this early in the morning. So I didn't want to wake anybody else up in the rest of the house with me being super loud. And since my kitchen is the farthest away from bedrooms, I just decided to come in the kitchen and not disturb anybody else who isn't ready or isn't getting up already. A little bit of this stuff, I do mean a little bit, and this may even be too much, believe it or not. Oh yeah, okay, so I'll just put the rest over here and we'll just try to make it work. How can I explain this? I'm not really happy with this month's box. I'm just gonna say it right now. First of all, I noticed that I got this eyeshadow primer in my box and it wasn't even featured in anything that was being advertised through BoxyCharm's Instagram. So when I got this in my box, I immediately knew where I saw this from before, and this was in, I believe, October's box, and I didn't get this primer because I had gotten something else. So it baffles me that even though I've been with BoxyCharm for about a year now, for about a year now, I'm still getting products that are not being featured. And I feel like, once again, they're just throwing things in my box. And I didn't really get what they were advertising, not really. I didn't get, you know, some of those lipsticks or lip glosses that I saw them advertise. I saw, and I'm gonna show you what this is. I saw them advertise this, but it wasn't until after the fact that I got my box. And this goes for about $21, supposedly. This is a holographic lip gloss. Oh, and if I didn't mention, the Luscious Angel Eyes Primer is $14. So, I mean, $14 for that eyeshadow primer, I mean, and you gotta be careful with this stuff, because if you do end up using too much, it's not gonna be a pretty sight. Your eyeshadow won't last at all. You will definitely get creasing, and, you know, that's not cute for anybody. Like, nobody likes that. So, I'm just gonna go in with my ColourPop. This is the BYOP. Yeah, the BYOP, where you build your own palette. So this is what I picked out. This up here is a matte finishing powder in medium dark. So I'm just gonna take this on this brush. This is a Luxie 660 brush. And I am going to put this all over my eyelid.
Okay, so I guess I'm gonna go straight away to the palette. I'm just gonna start doing my eyes. This is the Festival palette by Pure Cosmetics. This is a 12 piece pressed pigment palette. And you also get this little packet here of eyeshadow primer. I just used the other primer because that's what I got in my box. I mean, I do have my other palettes. I mean, I do have my other eyeshadow primers that I would prefer to use, but I'm just using that one because it comes in the box. So this is what the eyeshadows look like. You get two chunky glitters. You get about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 satin or glittery eyeshadows, and about 1, 2, 3, 4 matte colors. So as interesting as Wild Child looks, and that is the brightest color in this palette, I think I'm gonna go for a more neutrally type of look, only because I am going to the beach later and I want to be comfortable and not stared at. Okay, so now I'm gonna use my Ali Mad Cosmetics brush. I absolutely adore this brush, and I'm just gonna go in with the shade Epic. And I'm gonna tap off that excess, or just that extra powder, and I'm just putting this into my crease. I'm definitely gonna build this color up because it's not exactly the color payoff that I'm looking for just yet. I'm gonna take this brush by Sonia Kashuk. This is the blending crease brush. Take the shade Hidden Desert, and I'm taking this brush and I'm going to really pack this color on. Get that extra powder out, or really hope that it works well with me. And we're gonna put this underneath that transition shade that I first applied, or at least the color that I put on to act as a transition shade. Ready to go. Okay, I'm going back in. Ah, there it is. It's like a reddish type of shade. Like a reddish burnt orange type of shade. This is getting dramatic fast. Okay, I am going to take this brush right here. This is a e.l.f. contour brush, but I'm going to use it to pack in some color here on the ends. And I'm going to take the shade All Night. And it is a dark chocolate brown, or not even a dark. It's definitely a brown color. Looks more like on the chocolatey side to me. Looks a lot like something I saw in one of my Too Faced palettes. Maybe, but I feel like I need to clean this up a bit, but I will do just that. Okay, so the last color that I'm gonna put on my eyelids, let's see, I have some pretty good looking ones here. I really kind of want to incorporate glitter onto my eyelids, but at the same time I really don't. See, this is what 24K looks like, and this is what Firework looks like. And this is what they are swatched with my hands, and I got like a lot of glitter just stuck on my fingers. Now, even though these are beautiful shades, I don't think I want glitter all over my eyeball at the beach. So I think I'm just gonna take the shade Psychedelic, and this is a goldeny type of shade. Well, we're about to find out. Oh yeah, this is definitely gold. It's really pretty. I like it. I'm not mad at it. I mean, okay. I mean, it's not the greatest looking gold in the whole world. In fact, it feels kind of dryish. If that makes any sense, like it feels dry. It doesn't really feel... Okay, well, maybe going back in for a second. Almost patchy-like is what I was trying to say. Almost too dry of a patchiness, but going in that second time really proved to make it a little bit better. Okay, so the last thing I'm gonna take now is this brush right here. This is the Luxe 141 Mini Round Brush. And I want to take, what should I take and put under there? I'm gonna take Free Spirit. Okay, so I gotta admit, when I was first doing this eye color, wasn't sure if I liked it, but after I complete the other eye, I really like it. So, okay, so now I'm gonna work on my face, but I'm gonna put on this Wet n Wild lip balm. This is the one that not only moisturizes your lips, but look how cool that is. But it also tints your lips to like your, see that? So cool. It'll tint your lips to become a type of shade pink. Well, I'm gonna put this foundation here, and then I'm going to mix this other foundation here. So I have two foundations I'm working with. And I'm just gonna mix it up with my finger, so why not? Okay. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just start putting this all over my face. I don't know, I think I might need more of that other shade in there. Try to mix this up as best I possibly can. Yeah, that's better. Let me try to find my brush. Okay, so this is usually the brush that I use, and then I'm also going to be using this brush as well. This is just a regular brush that I got at Bath & Body Works, believe it or not. It's really cute. It has little stars inside and this acrylic handle, and it's this big fluffy brush. And then this brush is by Luxe. This is a 660 Precision Foundation brush, but I like to use it for powders. If you watched my BoxyCharms in the past, you might have seen me use it, and it didn't work really well with any of the, oh wait, what am I doing? What am I doing? Silly me, I am not done. Okay, so I haven't put on my concealer because I do have some discoloration under my eyes, and I don't feel like concealer by itself is gonna help. So that's why I do need to use this. This is by the brand Koki. This is Be Bright Eliminating Concealer. There are days when I don't need to use this under eye corrector, but days like this, I need it. So I just like to put it mainly where my problematic area is, which is in this area. I don't like to put it anywhere else. And now I'm just taking this Flower Beauty E01 brush. I like to use this as a concealer brush. This is typically an eyeshadow brush. And then I just like to go out with my finger and just warm it up a little bit. Take a little bit of concealer. And I'm using the Revlon, this is a Photo Ready Candid Concealer. I'm in the shade Medium, 040 Medium. And I'm just gonna take a little bit of this in this area and right there. Just a little bit. And with the same brush, I'm going to put this under my eye. with my ColourPop medium dark no filter sheer powder, and I'm just going to take that powder and just apply it under the eyes. The next two items left for my BoxyCharm is by the brand Luxie, and these brushes are $28. This is the Summer Days three-piece brush set, and it didn't occur to me to actually use the other brushes, but I'm going to show you what these look like even though I didn't use them. So this is, looks like a flat brush. You can definitely use this for like concealer or to really press on the your glitter pigment. So that would have been really great if I had used glitter. This is another brush where it would have been really great to like apply color all over the lid or just anything that you think you could use this with. And then this right here, I've seen a lot being used for highlight. I don't know if I like that for highlight because this does seem a little bit big, but I'm just gonna go in and use it anyway for highlight just to show you guys. And then the next thing I'm also gonna be using is by the brand Artiste Couture. This is the Diamond Glow Powder, and this goes for $27, and this is supposed to be a highlighter. It's flying everywhere. Okay, so I am just going to place this here where I normally, where I typically would place highlight. Oh. Okay, so in the back it says that this, I got the shade Diamond Glow Powder. No, I'm sorry. I got the shade Purple Dream. And at first, when you're first looking at it, it does not look purple at all. But now that I'm putting it on my cheeks, I can definitely see a purpley shift. So that is really cool. I just love when highlighters just, you know, amaze you, or they just do the craziest thing. I do like it. Okay, so now the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in with my bronzing shade. So let me just find my typical bronzing brush that I would use, which is this right here. This is by Sonia Kashuk. I don't know what this brush is called, but it's a dome brush, and it's really soft and it's just nice. And I'm just gonna use the shade Afternoon Delight. So the box comes out to about $126, but the way how I'm seeing it now is what's actually worth it. So you pay $21 a month for your box, but you know, comes everything that you get in the box always is over $100. And the way how I see it is, it's only worth it, it's only worth your $21 if you're actually going to use a lot of the products that you received. And in my mind, I would definitely use the brushes because, I mean, they're brushes. Why wouldn't I use them? And the palette is nice. I think it's okay. It's definitely your typical neutral eyeshadow. And this time, instead of a pop of color, you get two pops of color. And you do get two pressed on glitters. So, I mean, it's a nice palette. And I did like the Artiste Couture highlight. I really like that it definitely has a shift of purple. So that's really nice. I can't really talk and do my eyebrows. I'm just gonna do my eyebrows off camera and then I'll come right back. Okay, so the product that I used for my eyebrows is by Maybelline. This is the Brow Define Plus Fill Duo in Deep Brown. So the next thing I'm gonna use is my mascara. This is the IT Cosmetics Superhero Mascara. And I'm definitely starting to run out of this stuff, and I'm super excited because if you don't know, I'm gonna let you know, I don't like this mascara at all. And it's kind of hard to work with. When I first got this, I got this in a Sephora Play, when I used to have Sephora Play, a long time ago. I received a small little sample size of this stuff and I absolutely loved it. I don't know why that was so different than what this is. I mean, shouldn't it be the same? I mean, I don't know, but it just feels like it should be the same. And when I first got this, it was just super watery and very hard to use, and it did nothing for my lashes except clump them, which is what you're kind of seeing now. and I don't want to just start using another mascara, so I'm trying to use this one up and just get rid of it because I want to get my money's worth. And this was also given to me in an October box of BoxyCharm. See, I got this clump right here I'm trying to get out, but the more I keep trying to get out, the more mascara just keeps piling up. And see, this is the problem that I keep having with this mascara. I kind of just want to throw it away already and just get rid of it since it is starting to finish. But mama didn't raise a quitter. Okay, so as you can see, it definitely stained my lips. And this is what I'm going to use as my finishing product. And this is Neutrogena Hydro Boost Hydrating Lip Shine. So it's definitely just a nice lip gloss. A little bit sticky, and it's way too big to go back into its own bottle, but it's fine. Okay, so my makeup is complete. This is my first get ready with me, and this is not the end of the video. I'm definitely gonna be showing you guys what we do at the beach today, so stay tuned. Hey guys, so I'm here at the beach, as you can see. And we're gonna just enjoy the day in the sun. We're gonna have something to eat really quick, and then maybe go for a dip, but I don't know because it's really, really cold out here. It's really freezing. If you can see, my hair is like really blowing in the wind. So it's really windy out here. But check out my shirt. Ain't this cute? It says mermaid hair down here. Walmart, $10. See, my hair has been blown all over the place. So I'm just sitting in here. I just finished eating some lunch, and now I'm just munching on some Funyuns. So how do you guys like my makeup look? I hope it came out good. I definitely have sand on my face, so now I know why people don't like to wear foundation or they don't like to wear makeup when they come to the beach. Because I feel like I have little bits of sand on my face, and even though I'm trying to take it out of, like, off my face, it kind of feels pointless because I'm gonna go back out. I'm just sitting in the truck right now so I can have my food in peace so I don't have sand in my food, because the sand is really blowing out here. It's really cold, the wind is so loud, and I don't want sand in my food. So, I just came to sit in here for a little bit, and then I decided to chat just a little bit. Just right above me, like my scenery that I'm looking at right now, is the sand dunes. And you can see like how hard the wind is blowing, and I just, let me just show you. You can see here, there's a lot of wind blowing, and just over that cliff is definitely the sand dunes. And I'm not excited to go walking through there, so I'm not gonna do that because that's a challenge I do not accept. But let's just see what else there is to show you guys.
Okay guys, so as you saw in the previous clips, we were definitely driving on the sides of the ocean, well, the beach. So we were very, very close to when the tides are coming onto the shore. So as we were driving down that area, there was definitely water like splashing right into our car. It was kind of scary. I hope I captured most of it for you. Majority of what you see is a lot of people on ATVs, and apparently you can rent them and you can, you know, just chase yourself and your friends around the beach area with these little ATV four-wheel looking things. And of course, I'm not gonna do that. I'm too scared to do something like that. But I mean, it was interesting to show you guys that, you know, it's definitely pretty cool out here. Just too bad it's very windy and I'm just not like down with the whole windy scenario out here. But I am definitely sitting in the car right now looking at the beach, and to me this is comfort. But you know, it's whatever. Maybe if it wasn't so windy and so cold out there, I would probably be sitting on the sand looking at the oceany water. But I don't know. I guess let's see what else there is to show you guys, and if there's more to show you, then I will. If not, then we'll just see. Hey guys, so we're here at Black Bear Diner, and I'm gonna order fish and chips because I love the fish and chips here. And most likely I'm gonna get macaroni and cheese because I love the macaroni and cheese, but their noodles are weird. I don't know why, but it's the penne pasta instead of the regular elbow macaroni. But I'm not gonna complain because I love it. Also, I wanted to mention my eyeshadow is completely gone except for what's in my crease, and I only wore the eyeshadow primer for a couple of hours. So it's been on for about 12 hours, and as you can see, my eyeshadow is completely gone except for what's here. So I don't know. I don't really know if I like that eyeshadow primer or not. I mean, it was pretty early in the morning when I applied my eyeshadow and I did my whole makeup. In fact, I even removed my entire face makeup because how the wind was at the beach, it was so windy that it was blowing sand onto my face. So every time I touched my face, I could feel little sand particles on my face. So I just decided to just wipe everything away. The only thing that's left is my eyebrows, my mascara, and well, whatever's left of my eyeshadow. Overall, it's an okay primer. I've been trying it out for a while now, and it just seems to never last that long. And I've had great success with like my Too Faced Shadow Insurance Primer, even my Flower Beauty eyeshadow primer. I've had great success with those. But so far, I don't know. I'm just gonna continue trying it out. Maybe I need to play around with it a little bit more. So yeah, I guess. So this is the end of my vlog. This was my first Get Ready With Me, so I hope you enjoyed it. And thank you so much for following me around, even though it kind of didn't show too much, just because me and my family, we just enjoyed our day at the beach. We really didn't do much. It was just a day at the beach, relaxation. That's really what it was today. And now we're just getting some dinner. So if you made it this far, thank you so, so much. And please give my video a thumbs up. And subscribe if you haven't already, and comment down below. Do you like going to the beach? What's your favorite eyeshadow primer? Let's make conversation. Let's talk about stuff. Well, thank you so much. Bye.